Hi, everybody. This is Ralph Emery, and my guest on our upcoming show are...
Carl Smith.
Carl Smith and Dick Feller and all their happy songs. Some of their sad ones, too. Hello, everybody. Welcome again to our show. Come on in and join us. This is Ralph Emery on the air for Beech Nut Chewing Tobacco, your local True Value hardware stores, and for Bayer Aspirin. This week, it gives me great pleasure to bring you the talents of Mr. Carl Smith. Carl, welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's very nice to be here, Ralph.
You doing all right?
I'm doing fine.
You've mellowed in your old age, haven't
no,
you?
No, I haven't. I've got more sneaky.
Oh, have you?
Yes.
And our other guest is a fellow that writes some great songs, and he's been performing funny little songs like Making the Best of a Bad Situation and the credit card song, Dick Feller.
Hi.
Hi. Dick, aren't you related to the great baseball player Bob Feller?
I'm told that I am. I'm like a 19th cousin or something like that.
Oh, don't you stop counting at 19?
I think you stop counting at 6.
But you are distantly related.
Distantly, very distantly.
Have you ever met him? He's from Van Meter, Iowa.
Right? I didn't know that.
where are you from?
I'm from Missouri.
Okay, I guess somebody filtered down from Iowa somewhere in your family tree.
We're supposed to be related. The clan in Iowa and the clan in Missouri.
Huh?
The clan in Iowa and the clan in Missouri.
All right. I think it's best that we get on and open this show. Mr. Smith, what are you going to sing?
A little bit of Deep Water. Starting to care for you. You're getting me in deep water. Be careful what you do. Now you want a romance, but I'm seeking love. I know I'll regret it when it winding up in deep water. Why can't we just be friends? Now it's restless in this deep water. Between right and wrong, and my love is true as deep water. Your love won't last as long. Now will it lead me, and where will it end? I can't help but wish I only.
You've heard Carl Smith. Oh, you still call yourself the tall, tall gentleman?
I never did call myself the tall, tall gentleman. Well, somebody else called me that.
How tall are you?
I'm not that tall.
Sounds like you're 6'8".
Yeah, it does. I don't know. I recorded a song called Tall, Tall Gentleman, and they titled the album that. Then I done a television show in Canada, and then somebody on the introductions each show, they said, here's the tall, tall gentleman.
I see.
You know.
And basketball coaches started showing up with scholarships, right?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And they found out that I was overweight.
Overweight. All right, King Size, you've heard Carl Smith sing Deep Water. Fire can strike anytime, anywhere, without warning. So True Value Hardware Stores suggest you safeguard your family night and day with a Home Sentry smoke alarm by General Electric. You mount it on the ceiling, it'll detect smoke before you could even see it and sound a loud warning that could save your family's lives. It's available in house current or battery-operated models. Prices start at $28.88. The General Electric Home Sentry Smoke Alarm, just one of the many values at participating True Value Hardware stores.
Suffering from minor pains of arthritis and morning stiffness? Take two Bayer-timed release aspirin to relieve the pain before going to bed. They work while you sleep to help you wake without morning stiffness. Bayer timed release aspirin. Each tablet has made special so you take it only once in 8 hours. Remember, read and follow all label directions carefully and get Bayer timed release aspirin. It's made to work overtime.
My guests this week, as we have pointed out, are Carl Smith and Dick Feller. Carl, is it true that you retired from show business for a while?
No. <Huh? laughs> No.
I heard that rumor. I heard you were moving to Florida, things like that.
Well, you know, you really can't pay any attention to what you hear. Now, I tell you what happened. I took off. I really did. But I never had any intention of retiring. I never told anybody I was retiring. And I had some dates that I canceled, and I took off for about 7 or 8 months, about 8 months. So I pick up the papers, and it says Carl Smith retired, and I said, "Oh, goody!"
What'd you do with all that time on your hands?
Oh, I stayed very, very busy. I really did.
Now, I know that you have a ranch out right here near Nashville. You raise cattle?
Yeah, and at that time, I was very much involved in horses, and during that 8 months, I sold about 40-something horses.
You sold 40 horses?
Yes.
What do you want to be in show business for?
Well, them horses eat, and that's the reason I sold them. I had to go back in show business to support the rest of them.
Well, now, did you have some idea of moving to Florida?
No. You know, in general conversation, I said, I'd like to live in Florida sometime. I thought I might move down there sometime.
Oh,
yes. And so the next thing I knew, I ran into somebody in town the other day and said, "Hey, what are you doing up here? I thought you was in Florida." And I said, "No."
You mean somebody just ran and called the newspaper?
Yeah, well, I don't know. I don't really know. My name gets in the paper so seldom because, you know, I'm not a criminal.
Okay.
Okay. And I don't get in the paper much. And when they put it in there, I just look at it and say, "Boy, ain't that good."
Now, you got a pretty nice neighbor over there. You ever go over there and borrow stuff off of him?
I never do see my neighbor. My neighbor is so rich and famous, he stays gone all the time.
We're talking about Tom T. Hall. You don't get over there?
No, I go by his house every day or two and see who pushed over his mailbox that night.
You mean they do that to poor Tom?
Oh, Tom's mailbox has got to be, since he lived out there, somebody laid it on the ground at least 25 times. In fact, just a couple of days ago, I went by there, and he'd just lay it over so pretty, and they don't bend it or anything. They just lay it over on the ground real neat.
What do you do that for?
I don't do that. Since I've mellowed, I wouldn't do that.
Oh, since you've mellowed, yeah. All right. Dick Feller over here hit the scene a few years ago with a song called Biff the Friendly Purple Bear. Then he came, you know who he reminds me of, Carl? He reminds me of Robert Lund doing the Talking Blues. Did you ever hear of Robert Lund?
Sure. He had the original Talking Blues.
Yeah, and he used to just play the guitar and sort of talk his songs.
Right.
And you remind me a lot of him.
I think I probably learned from Woody Guthrie, Robert Lund, Cisco Houston, those people who came out of the 40s. They did a lot of that.
And this song you're about to do, it's a pretty funny song, but you've got some old jokes in here.
They were pretty old jokes. I figured not everybody had heard them, you know. They were due for a revival or something.
All right, for another laugh, and this fits an awful lot of situations. Here's Dick making the best of a bad situation.
Well, I know a man, he's a hard-working man. He gets up real early, and he goes downtown. About 15 minutes after he's been gone, there's a big milk truck pulls up on the lawn. That milkman rushes up to the door, but that man's wife's waiting in a kimono, and she plants a big old kiss on his cheek, and they go inside. And that truck never moves for an hour or two while it's running by business. One day I called him aside and told him what was going on while he was gone. He said, "Well, I guess that's so, but do you know we're never out of milk or cottage cheese or yogurt, ice cream, or none of them other cowy things." I guess he's making the best of a bad situation. Don't want to make waves, can't you see? He's just making the best of a bad situation. Reckon I'd do the same if it was me. Now an old man, he's educated man, he's alligator wrestler. He jumps right in there and grabs them long green boogers by whatever you grab them long green boogers by. Well, one day he's got a full Nelson on this big alligator when this other alligator sneaks up and bites his right ear, plumb off. Didn't bat an eye, just crawled off in the shade and went to sleep. The alligator, not the man, well, it's none of my business. One day I said, well, it's sure too bad about that little accident that you had, because now your hat's going to fall down over your eyes and you can't ever be a gypsy because you don't have no place to wear a gold earring. He just looked me right straight in the eye and said, huh? I guess he's making the best of a bad situation. Don't want to make waves, can't you see? He's just making the best of a bad situation. I reckon I'd do the same if it was me. Now I know, lady, she's a mighty fine lady, got a heart of gold, she wouldn't harm a fly. She's just trying to get by and keep her house in order. But you know that her husband, he works so hard that he come unglued, he come unwrapped, he just snapped, he thinks he's a chicken. That's right, one of them cackling Colonel Sanders types. Roosts in a bush by the side of the house. Well, it's none of my business. One day I said, have you ever thought about finding him a doctor that could make him well? And she said, well, I have now and then. But then again, he don't eat much, just chicken feed and all that pecking in the ground don't hurt nothing. Heaven knows we can use the eggs. I guess she's making the best of a bad situation. Don't want to make waves, can't you see? She's just making the best of a bad situation. Reckon I'd do the same if it was me. We're all just making the best of a bad situation. We're all in this together, you and me.
I'm curious, Dick, how, will you tell me how old you are?
How old I am?
Yes.
I'm 32.
All right, now, where were you when these jokes came out the first time?
I actually only heard one old joke in there.
Which one? About the eggs?
Yeah.
Okay.
The other ones are new jokes, aren't they?
No, they're all old jokes.
Oh, I thought they were new. When I wrote them, they were new.
Huh?
When I wrote them, they were new.
You came out of what town of Missouri?
Brunau, Missouri.
How you spell that?
B-R-O-N-A-U-G-H.
What does it mean?
It's a German fella's name who came and founded the town and built the four houses that are there.
Oh, big town, huh?
Yeah. It had 214 people. That's pretty good, I thought.
What, did y'all have a main street and a library? And
We had a main street, yeah. We didn't have a library.
You have a store?
We had two stores at one time.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is it still there?
No, there's one store.
Is the town still there?
At one time. Yeah, the town's still there.
Have a post office?
Sure. Post office, a gas station.
Wow.
I think there's three or four stop signs.
What's the old joke about the town so small somebody got the book out of the library?
Yeah.
All right, you've heard Dick Feller making the best of a bad situation. Carl, who's next?
Who's next? Yeah. Oh, yes, my pal Tanya. Tanya has got some very good horses now.
Oh, really?
She
in the horse business?
Yes, sir. Tanya Tucker and son Antonio Stroll.
When I was a child down in South Carolina, soon the Saturday sun went on down. My folks and sister would go and leave me home all alone, going to that big square dance in town. Well, my old radio would play that old Opry show, so I never got lonesome or blue. I'd fall asleep in my chair and dream that I was right there, just a-singing the whole night through. When my folks would come home, they'd be humming a song. Mom would smile and say, child, don't you know, there ain't a thing in this world to make you fall in love, girl, like the San Antonio Stroll. Well, the day finally come when my mama said, hun, it's about time you came with us as well. Well, I had me a time, yes, I danced all the night till they rang that old cracked midnight bell. Then the lights went down low, the fiddler picked up his bow, and he played something stately and slow. and my sister Eileen and her husband to be. They held hands and began to stroll. I've been away for a while, but it still brings a smile when I think of the way that it goes. Now I'll sing it to you just so we both can do that old San Antonio stroll. San Antonio stroll.
Miss Tanya Tucker on the show doing the San Antonio stroll.
The minds teach a man what he can't and he can't. And no mind makes exceptions for you. You learn to stay on your guard, looking out for your part. You learn beech nuts that are back of you chew. Like my daddy told, when you go after coal, you're not down there to take in the view. You keep respect for the mind, concentrate all the time. Of course, beech nuts that are back of you chew. What makes beech nuts such a traditional favorite? It's cause beech nut just keeps on getting better. It's a moister, more satisfying chew. Next time you're buying chewing tobacco, try beech nut. You won't be disappointed. Then when your shift's done, you come back to the sun. You and the boys hoist a few. It ain't such a bad life, she ain't such a bad wife. And you got your beech nut tobacco to chew.
Your mama call you Dickie?
They used to call me Dickie Dean.
Why?
I don't know why I told you that. That's a well-kept secret right up until now.
Well, Dickie Dean, how about the next song?
The next song is going to be by old Charlie Pryde. A song called Hope You're Feeling Me.
You run out of breath?
Am I?
Yeah.
No, not yet.
I feel like we're going to have to pump you up before the show's over. Here's Charlie Pryde.
No one could hold me. No one could control me. But now my future is up to you. Your loving can shape me, make me or break me. Oh, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you. This feeling is crazy, only you can save me from this love thing that I've got for you. Your love is a potion, Lord, and I need a notion. Oh, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you. All these changes got me going in circles. First I turn away, then turn right back to you. Well, I need your loving to keep me from sinking. Oh, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you. Wanna win when I gamble, no need to ramble. I double my loving when I gave it to you. I gotta do it with you, I can't do it without you. Oh, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you. All these changes got me going in circles. First I turn away, then turn right back to you. Well, I need your loving to keep me from sinking. Oh, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you. Yes, I hope you're feeling me like I'm feeling you.
Charlie Pride, smiling and singing, "Hope You're Feeling Me." Let's pause just a moment here for Tennessee Ernie Ford.
He'll understand and say, "Well done."
Isn't that a beautiful, restful sound? It's from the special two-record album I have for all our listeners. There are 31 sacred songs in all. And I want everybody to have one of these albums. To get your own This Country's Gospel album, send a check today for $5.98 to Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee. That's just $5.98 for all 31 of these great gospel songs to Ralph Emery, 110 21st Avenue South, Box 61, Nashville, Tennessee. Our zip is 37203.
He'll understand and say,
"This Carl Smith, and I'd like to sing you a song that I recorded at one of the greatest songwriters and one of the first great country songwriters in Nashville music wrote. It's called Foggy River, and his name is Fred Rowe.
Your love is colder than a foggy river, blowing over a heart of stone. You left me stranded on this foggy river, drifting helpless and alone. Can't escape this broken heart of mine. There's no freedom anymore. Oh, heaven help me on this foggy river. Help me find the distant shore."
Mercy, that's a tough song. That's Carl Smith, one of the old country songs, Foggy River. You're listening to the Ralph Emery Show with me, or Carl Smith and Dick Feller, and we'll get back to them momentarily. Right now, Miss Loretta Lynn is going to cut down on a song.
Ever since I can remember, and the people that I meet just suit me fine. But anywhere you see me going, chances are that I've done been back. So when I need a little peace of mind, I go home, home. glisten, a white rail fence, and watch the meadow glisten. There's a newborn baby calf down in the barn. Have your morning cup of coffee in the country air, oh listen. It's 100 million miles away from home. I go home,
home, where the mockingbirds are singing pretty melodies. Home, home,
where nothing short of heaven's waiting there for me.
That sweet little old Loretta Lynn singing Home. I want to ask, we're going to play Biff the Friendly Purple Bear here in a moment, but Dick Feller, this came out during a Christmas season a few years ago, didn't it?
Right. It wasn't actually meant to be a Christmas song. It just happened that way. But it kind of fit the season, you know. So some stations just started to play it like every year. You know, it was a kind of a seasonal type song, but that wasn't actually what I wrote it for.
I presume with that in mind, they don't play it after the 25th of December then.
They tend to stop playing it on about midnight, I think.
I think
the
25th. We discussed this one other time. Songs get typed as Christmas songs, like Jingle Bells doesn't have Christmas
right.
in it. Winter Wonderland doesn't mention Christmas, but they're always performed at that time.
Yeah.
Pistol Pack and Mama don't have Christmas in it.
That's right, Carl. Well, is there a story behind this song?
Only the story maybe how I wrote it. Like, Johnny Cash at one time was doing a Christmas album, and he asked me if I'd write him a children's album, not a Christmas album, if I'd write him a couple of children's songs. So I wrote Biff the Friendly Purple Bear and one other song. And he liked the Purple Bear, but he said it's too heavy. Yeah, kids wouldn't understand it. So he didn't do it, so I did it.
I see. Well, heavy or not, it is.
Heavy or not, here we come.
Yeah, Harlan Howard once said, I would rather write a standard than a hit any day. And this has become a standard, plays every year. Here's Dick Feller.
Now, I was a play horse you pull with a string on wheels where my legs should be. And he was the boy who pulled the toy. For the longest time, there was just us two, the boy and the horse that was me. Until the day the purple bear came to live in the treehouse tree. Well, it was early one spring, I was tied by my string in a field of the make-believe farm, when around the house the boy and the bear came marching arm in arm. This is Biff, said the boy to me, he's the friendly purple bear. And Biff stooped down and stroked my mane with a paw of purple hair. Biff has come to stay, said the boy, and pretend with me and you. And he can do anything that a boy and a toy believe purple bears can do. And taking the cue, Biff bowed from the waist, then leaped and clicked his heels, then down to the ground in three somersaults that ended in four cartwheels. He whirled and twirled and stood on his head. The boy giggled and slapped his side. And I laughed so hard that wooden tears rolled out of my painted eyes. So Biff came to stay in the treehouse tree, and long days came without end. For the boy and the toy and the purple bear and serious games of pretend. I like the cowboy game with the boy as sheriff and Biff as the bandit king. That always ended with all the outlaws in the jail for the long rope swing. And the great pony race that lasted for days around the flower bed. Ah, that was a tough one. But lucky for us, I won by a wooden head. And the day we entered the pirate's cove, neath the bush on the alley side, Biff with a sword and a paper hat and a patch across a purple eye. Well, there was always a danger of outlaws or Indians or creatures from outer space. And without the courage of the three of us, we might have lost the whole place. But we were bound by the code of the musketeers, and such golden hours were shared by the freckle-faced boy and the wooden horse toy. and Biff the purple bear. But as summers passed, the boy grew taller and his voice took a strange new ring. And his visits were few to the treehouse tree and never to the long rope swing. Biff the purple bear grew sad as he climbed down the treehouse tree. He shook his head, "I'm afraid," he said, "he's forgotten you and me. It seems, old wooden friend of mine, we've outlasted his boyhood years." Then he turned and was gone across the lawn in a trail of purple tears. Now I've been put to pasture in the old treehouse, but at times I've seen from afar a strange tall boy who mows the lawn and tinkers about his old car. But just today I looked past the house and down the sidewalk, I swear, came a new little boy with a wooden horse toy, followed by a purple bear.
Our guest star, Dick Feller, the story of Biff the Friendly Purple Bear.
Suffering from minor pains of arthritis and morning stiffness? Take two Bayer-timed release aspirin to relieve the pain before going to bed. They work while you sleep to help you wake without morning stiffness. Bayer-timed release aspirin. Each tablet has twice the usual amount of aspirin, made special so you take it only once in 8 hours. Remember, read and follow all label directions carefully and get Bayer-timed release aspirin. It's made to work overtime.
Who'd think to look for adventure at a hardware store? You can if it's a True Value hardware store. Their West Point bicycles offer your family adventure together outdoors. Flashy high-risers for the kids, 3 and 5-speed touring bikes for adults. Even precision-made 10-speed racers. For kids, their basic transportation. For you, a chance to see the outdoors as a part of it instead of just passing through it. West Point bicycles offer family adventure together outdoors. Just a few of the values at participating True Value hardware stores. Oh, Carl Smith sitting over here. That's an affectionate old Carl. I'm not referring to your age.
I appreciate you. I was going to correct you there, Ralph.
How long have you been in show business, Carl?
How long have I been in show business? That's a good question. I've been recording 25 years. And I was in it. I had my first job in radio, playing bass in a bluegrass band in 1944.
Whose bluegrass band was it?
A group called the Brewster Brothers. Or Kaz Walker in Knoxville, yeah. Tennessee.
Now, you worked around Knoxville a long time, didn't you?
I worked there three or four different times. And I also went to Asheville, North Carolina, and worked a year. And I went to Augusta, Georgia, and worked a year. And back to Knoxville, and then to Nashville.
Was it... Now, I've heard entertainers say, if you're ever a sideman, it's hard to break the sideman image if you are for a long time. Was it hard for you?
Well, it wasn't hard for me because I didn't have no image. You know,
when I first started playing records, the biggest acts in the business, and we talked about this before, were Lefty Frizzell, Hank Williams, Carl Smith. I imagine Red Foley would have been in that group around 1950-51.
Right.
And what was that we were talking about the chart one time? Would you tell them that story about how Lefty Frizzell dominated the chart?
I run up on a chart and out of one of the trade papers, Billboard, I think, when they had just the top 10. You know, they used to have the top 10 most played bestsellers and jukebox, 10 records. And Lefty had 5, and I had 4, and Hank Williams had 1 of the top 10.
What'd y'all treat poor old Hank so miserably for?
Well, poor old Hank had the old 9 the week before. He wasn't doing too bad.
What were your 4?
I don't remember. I really don't. I couldn't tell you. It was, I think, Let's Live a Little, If Teardrops Were Pennies, and Mr. Moon, and I believe Nothing as Sweet as My Baby. They was all back-to-back. It's 2 records.
Now, this is when both sides of your record could hit.
Right.
And they would chart both sides of your record.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You mean the top 10 just had 3 guys in it?
That's all there was that week.
You still got that chart?
I still got it somewhere. I'm trying to find it, really. I've misplaced it, and I got to find it for personal reason.
Well, I think you'd frame that.
Well, I got other things I can frame,
Oh,
you know.
All right. You hadn't changed a whole lot, Carl. What are you going to sing here?
What am I going to sing? The Girl I Love.
This an Eddie Raven song?
This is an Eddie Raven song. It's a pretty song. I don't sing it too well, but it's a pretty song.
The girl I love wears faded cotton dresses, and sometimes holds her hand. Her smile is true and always sweet as morning, and any time I need her love, it's there. The girl I love, I guess you'd say she's country, just as country as I am myself. That ruined my day. Her eyes light up and laughter falls so easy. Tomorrow is a million days away. The girl I love, I guess you'd say myself. Her faith in me is strong. She's the one that I lean on. And friend, there's never been nobody else. And friend, there's never been nobody else.
Hey, you did all right on there, Carl.
Thank you.
Shock me. Carl Smith singing The Girl I Love. All right, Carl, since you've got the mic, you brought on her sister a while ago.
I sure did.
Might as well bring on the other one.
Very, very pretty girl, LaCosta. Do I say that right?
Yes.
You know, from East Tennessee, I ought to say LaCosta. that's how they'd say it. LaCosta. And this house runs on sunshine.
Locks don't work and doors don't open, walls are damp and wind is broken. Still these walls are home, sweet home to me. Bread and wine and milk and honey, we got love, we don't need money. Come on in and join the family.
This house runs on sunshine, this house runs on peace and love. This house runs on laughter with the help from up above.
If you need some friendship, well, that's what we plenty of.
This house runs on sunshine, peace and love.
Kind of squeaky, roofs are low and kind of leaky. Still this helps to let the sunshine in. You can feel the love beginning when you hear the children singing, home sweet home, and let the love shine in.
This house runs on sunshine. This house runs on peace and love. This house runs on laughter with the help from up above. If you need some friendship, well, that's what we plenty of. This house runs on sunshine, peace and love. Sunshine, this house runs on peace and love. This house runs on laughter with the help from up above. If you need some friendship, well, that's what we plenty of. This house runs on sunshine, peace and love. This house runs on sunshine, peace and love.
All right, that's pretty, LaCosta, and this house runs on sunshine. Let's listen to Loretta Lynn.
I like the old time, preach and pray and sing and shout. I like the old time, reading of God's word.
Neighbor, I want to send you that record and 30 others of my favorite gospel songs. Red Foley's Peas in the Valley, Old Time Religion sung by Joe Mavis, Marty Robbins' What God Has Done. The list goes on and on. There are 31 songs in this big two-record album that I want to send to you. All you do is send 598 to me, Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110, 21st Avenue South in Nashville. That's only 598 for 31 of the most beloved sacred songs of all to Ralph Emery, Box 61. 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Hallelujah, glory. I like the old time worship of the Lord.
We're sitting here talking about dancing while these records have been playing. Can you dance, Carl?
Not a lick.
Goldie ever get you out and try to make you dance?
Yeah. And it takes quite a bit.
You step on her
feet? Two-fifths.
How about you, Dick? Can you dance?
I'm afraid not. I played for so many of them, I never did learn to dance.
You mean played for dances?
Yeah, a lot of...
You play a lot of guitar, don't you?
I don't know. That's kind of debatable. I play a lot of old, dumb, corny licks, I guess.
Well, on your records, it always says finger-picking. List all the musicians and finger-picking, it says, but Dick Feller. So apparently you play the lead.
Yeah.
That's so you can sign for leader, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, I know you know this old boy, Carl. Why don't you bring him up?
That old boy? Let's dedicate this song to him. Wherever he's at, there's a chicken nearby. Ray Price, and if you ever change your mind.
Girl, it can't go on like this. You say you're feeling trapped and locked in, and you long to see the part of life you've missed, and travel roads to places you ain't been. You know I hate to see you go, especially after all this time. So here's one thing I think that you should know. I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I know the time has come when you must see your own way. And if that's how it's got to be, I can only hope you find the road someday that brings you back to me. I know this life has got you down, waking up each day to face the same old grind. But if there's no one selling dreams in town, I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I'll be here if you ever change your mind.
Hey, that's a pretty song by Ray Price. You call him the Chicken Man?
Mm-hmm.
Now, he likes to go to these places where they have these game roosters, doesn't he?
He likes to furnish the equipment.
I see. You've heard Ray Price on the show, and if you ever change your mind. Well, it seems like we just got here, but we've got to go. Dick Feller, I thank you very much.
I thank you.
And Carl Smith? Carl Smith?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
I thank you.
And I'll see you tomorrow, both of you.
All right, fine.
Our show presented by your local True Value Hardware Store, by Bayer Aspirin, and by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco. This is Ralph Emery thanking you for listening.